Is there a loo I could...
Yes, right there by the front door. We call that Frasier's bathroom. That's why we've monogrammed all the towels with his initials.
You all take a leave of your senses.
She started it, hugging all over him.
What is your problem? Frasier said the only reason we were doing this was because you wanted to give him the brush off.
Well, I changed my mind. Didn't you see my signals?
Gee, I must have missed them. It must have been during one of my blackouts.
Wait. There's no need to fight. Look, I'll flip a coin. Oh, good news, Roz.
Oh, shut up. You think with all your dozens and dozens of men, you could at least leave one for me?
Dozens? Did you tell her that?
Well, forgive me for keeping track.
Why are you fighting over the man anyway? He's got all the charm of a cricket bat.
You're right. You know what, Daphne? You want him? You can have him. You can have him. He's yours.
Oh, yes. Fat chance I've got now that you've told him I'm pregnant. How am I supposed to get rid of this bloody baby?
Clive. Coffee?
No, thank you. I really should be going.
No, please. I know what you must think, but we're not what we seem.
You certainly aren't. Look, I know I'm a guest here, so I've kept silent so far, but I'm sorry I must speak. You're the most appalling family I've ever met. You, breaking up with your wife over a pair of opera glasses. And you, looking down your nose at me the entire time you're showing off your posh flat. Well, for your information, mate, I don't think there's anything remotely special about your bathrooms. And you two women, flirting shamelessly with me right in front of your husbands. You having just reconciled with Frasier, and you carrying Niles' baby. Well, I pity your child, Daphne, and I pity any good Manchester girl that comes here to this vile coffee-swilling Sodom and lets it change her like it's changed you.
But I haven't changed, really. We're not the awful people you think we are.
No, the truth is we've been lying to you all night.
Yes.
Well, I don't care to be lied to anymore. Goodbye, Daphne. Maris, Dr. Crane. I'll never understand how two men like you could have been spawned by that sweet, courageous old astronaut.